Sport is full of comeback stories. This year, we were all amazed when Paul Scholes returned to Manchester United just months after retiring. But there's one revival story that tops the lot. I flew to Houston, Texas, to meet the king of the comeback. George Foreman's always been someone that's intrigued me. He won his title back 20 years after he first lost it. At the age of 19, he was an Olympic gold medalist. He went on to become the heavyweight champion of the world.
What a heavyweight prospect this man must be.
He then lost to Muhammad Ali in the Rumble in the Jungle. He only lost one more fight to Jimmy Young, but something happened in that dressing room that caused him to retire.
Great. Hey there. Hi. Good to see you there,
good
friend.
To see you. All right. You all right?
I'm going to live the good life now.
You've lived it already, haven't you?
Trying to.
Have a seat.
Okay.
George, just tell me, what happened that night when you just lost to Jimmy Young in the dressing room? You say that God arrived.
I had a lot of hate in my heart, and I was going to get to be the number one contender again and get my title back. That was my whole focus. Then when I lost to Jimmy Young, to meet up with religion like that, it just blew me away. I didn't know what to think. I had to go on the street corners and preach, and I'd cut all my hair off. My beloved mustache was gone, and I'd gain all this weight, and people would actually pass me down the street. They'd hear me preaching and wouldn't stop. And I stopped and said, you know what? I'm George Foreman. Yes, I fought Muhammad Ali, Joe Frazier, but I'm here preaching for Jesus Christ. And they'd stop.
So you went away from boxing for 10 years, and then you came back.
When I'd put all of my effort into the George Foreman Youth Center, I started helping kids go to college, and I'd run out of money, and I just couldn't let this place close. I had to find a way to keep the George Foreman Center going, and I had to go to work, and I had one profession. It was boxing.
How much harder was it second time around?
The second time around in boxing is rougher because you have to work harder. I was 315 pounds, so not only did I have to work out to get in shape, but I have to lose all of this weight. And no one took me serious. Everyone said he's out for the big bucks. And these guys, with young guys, would come out and challenge me. One knockout after another. It was pretty easy. How you like me now? How you like me now? The next thing you know, I was back in the contendership and fighting for the title.
Like, oh, what a shot! Oh my goodness!
Boxing seems to be the one sport where boxers retire and then come back. Bruno Bugni, yourself. Why is that? Can't you? Don't you get enough of it when you're in your...
I think the easiest thing about boxing is getting into the sport. The hardest part is to walk away, leave it alone. We all have to be crazy to box in the first place. And the sad thing about it, that craziness lingers on. We don't know when to quit. You just have to have someone in your life to tell you enough is enough. Most boxers can't find that person. There's always that one purse and that one punch you think you can land. Always. I think I'll be sitting there at 70 years old thinking, I got one more fight.
Who was the one person that kind of said to you, come on, step aside now?
My wife told me. I told you, I argued with my wife. Get one good fight. I knew I could do it. I was going to even pay the number one contender to beat him. And she said, I said, I can still do it. Don't you believe in me? She said, isn't that the way you want to leave the sport, believing that you can still do it? I said, yep. She said, leave it. And I left it.
What about the George Foreman grill?
For the first time in my life, I learned to sail. I heard a lady say once, if you learn to sail, you'll never starve. And I would sell religion on the street corners. Finally, a friend said to me, why don't you get your own product?
Potato wedges.
Uh-huh.
Steak?
Sure.
Paninis?
Easy. I learned then that boxing was not about hit and run. It was about selling. So I boxed, boom, sure did hurt. And then I'd get a chance, yes, try the George Foreman grill or whatever. And so I spent the latter part of my boxing career in the ring selling things. Boxing was least of it.
What does retirement mean to George Foreman?
There's no such thing as retirement with George Foreman. I think that's the worst thing that could happen to any professional man, especially an athlete, because you retire, your next thing is die. And I'm afraid of that, so I haven't retired. I don't even think the word.
George keeps busy. He's got five sons all called George, and one of them's a promising heavyweight. And at his own church just along the road, he continues to preach three times a week.